becoming an amazing songwriting partnership with Mick. Did you, in those early days, kind of fulfill the same roles each time whenever you wrote a song? Was it kind of one of you doing one thing and the other one doing another thing, or did you share?
If some songs are different than others, but I would say that in the early days, basically, I'd provide the riff and sometimes the idea, you know, just the phrase. I mean, for instance, you know, this could be the last time. Just done by a more remote control these days, basically. But eventually we have to come together and decide. At the same time, in a way, I miss the urgency and the closeness that was forced upon us in those days. At the same time, I'm quite proud that we could get over that of not being that close and still being able to do things together. You know, you just adapt, kind of improvise, overcome.
Yeah.
project that one of the main things people would zero in on straight away was what you were going to say about Mick.
Of course.
I mean, did you think about how you were going to approach that?
To a certain point, I just my main point about all of that was to explain first what the Stones, I've gone through, and that there was certainly, a split, which I don't think Mick, up until right now, has realized how deep a cut that was to, not just to me, to the rest of the band, to the Stones, the whole thing of making side deals, and saying things like, oh, the Stones are a millstone. That's an unfortunate phrase around my neck. It became a very difficult period, the late 80s, up until 90. As I used to call it World War III, without damage, without any collateral damage anyway. you've got to realize that, hey, we've been doing this already by then for over 20 years. And being forced in the pressure cooker all of that time and two very strong egos involved, there was inevitably, in a way, going to be, when the pressure cooker pops, and the whistle goes off. And I realized this fairly early in that schism. And my main thing about it really was, if we can get over this, then we're a real band, because this is a deep cut, and maybe, one didn't realize how deep a cut it was, And then as far as the book is concerned, I'm going to say that this stuff happened 30 years ago, in fact, a little bit more. And it was just something we went through, and it was something I had to explain. I mean, if I'd have left it out, it would be Enid Blyton, wouldn't it?